Hello and welcome to another Krita tutorial. In this tutorial, I will be covering all the basics and some of the advanced functions of the layers panel. And hopefully by the end of this video, you will be able to use layers more efficiently. So let's get started. When you open Krita, the layers panel will be on the right, between your color selector and brush preset. In the layers panel, you will notice that there are two layers open by default. One is the background layer and the other is layer 1. You can paint on the layer 1, but if you try to paint on the background layer, you will be unable to do this because that layer is locked. You can unlock this layer and paint on it, but I would strongly suggest that you don't, because if you make any mistake on this layer and you are unable to undo it for some reason, the only option you will have will be to erase it, and when you do, the transparent pixels will become visible. Of course, you can fix this by making a layer underneath the background layer and filling it with color. But all this trouble can be avoided by keeping the background layer locked. If you want to make a new layer, click on this plus icon or press the insert key. If you want to duplicate a layer, you will click on the duplicate icon next to the new layer icon or use the short key Ctrl plus J. You can move a layer down by using this icon and up by using this one. To view layer properties, click on this icon. But you don't really need this because most of the functions in this window are available directly on the layers panel. To delete a layer, click on the trash can icon or press Shift Delete. Now keep in mind that if you just press the delete key, you will be deleting whatever you have painted on the selected layer and not the layer itself. Only by pressing Shift Delete, you will delete the selected layer. To hide a layer, click this eye icon, and to make it visible again, click the same icon. If you want to rename a layer, double click on it. Type in the desired name and press enter. But if you work in multiple layers and renaming all of them is not possible, simply hover over a layer and it will show what you have painted on it along with other details. Or you can resize the thumbnail by clicking on this icon, adjusting the slider until the thumbnail is large enough for you to see the element of that layer in just one glance. You can change the opacity of an object from here. You can access the blending modes from this drop-down menu. I will not be discussing these today because I have discussed these in detail in my previous video, which I will link in the card above. So you can check that out after you are done with this one. If you want to select multiple layers, hold down Shift and click on the last layer you want to select. This way, all the layers in between will also get selected in one go. But if you want to click and choose between the layers, hold down the Ctrl key and click on the layer you want to select. To put layers in a group, select the layers, right-click on the topmost selected layer, select Group, and then click on Quick Group, or use the short key Ctrl G. To ungroup, press Ctrl Alt G. If you want to convert two or more layers into one, right-click on the top selected layer and click on Merge with layer below, or use the short key Ctrl E. Merging layers also helps in making your Krita documents smaller, which can be helpful for low-end computers that cannot handle heavy files. If you want to paint inside an object but you want to avoid the paint from getting out of that object, you will click on this transparent pixel icon. This will lock the pixels on the selected layers and you can safely paint inside the area. Trying to paint outside of this area where there are no visible pixels will not work. In this way, you are only able to work directly on the selected layer. But what if you want to work inside the object but on a different layer? Right-click on the layer, select Group, and then Quick Clipping Group. Now, if you paint on this mask layer, you will be able to stay inside the shape while working on a different layer. But remember that every time you make a new layer inside a clipping group, you need to click on this A icon called Inherit Alpha. Otherwise, whatever you have painted will not be contained inside the main object. You can also contain an image using clipping group. Bring in the image that you want. And place it inside the clipping group. Click on Inherit Alpha and there you go. You can use this for containing textures like metal, concrete, fabric, leather, etc. Get creative with it. So these are all the features that I personally use and know about. I hope this tutorial was helpful for you. If you want more tutorials, comment them down below or check out the playlist of my existing Krita tutorials. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!